Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial on JasperReport. Today I'm going to show you a basic way of creating JasperSub report in JasperReport Studio, iReport Studio. And what we want to do here is a small introduction. We use now here is simple database coming with JasperReport. And one way we'll have a product table which is having a one-to-many relationship to positions here, which are the subproducts. And you mean like one product here will have many subproducts. And physically in the reports, our reports will look like this one, master details. And here we have the product names, and under here you have some subreports. So this is what we are trying to do now. And in order to achieve that, let's go to our JasperReport Studio and create a new project. We create a new JasperReport Studio project here. Next, here we enter the name. We may call it sub report tutorial 01. Bam. And then next here we are going to create a blank new report. Blank report that we call master report. We go to next, and here we are going to select a sample database. Sorry, not responding. We let promote cancel. We go back, and here we are going to. Here is our table. Here is our product table with these attributes. So here we are going to just write select all from products, and we go next. We select all fields. Next, we don't group by anything, and we click finish. So here is our blank report. And then the first thing that we are going to add now to be to add the title. Title here, what we do is just try to scroll all these things, make it fit this area, and here we call it master details report. That is it, only that. And we come to the styling here. We come to the styling here, label text, center, and here Algerian. Then we come here, we put it to 26. just move it up. Then that one is done. So the next thing that we are going to do now is to go to the field, select all fields, then come here and put them. By default, Jasper Report will fit them in the whole area. So that one is done. Here we select the names here. And why not this one? No. We select these names here and go to static field. Static field, and here you are going to select maybe that one, and we increase the font to 14. Not bad. Then we just move a bit this one up. Yeah, same thing goes here to the text field. We try to design them, and here you are going to put them to the center. Maybe also try to give we give them like 16. And then what we do next now is that we try to hide those fields that we don't need, those sections of the reports that we don't need, the footer. The summary. And also the page header, this one we don't need. So here is our first part of the project, which is correct if you preview it. We can see that okay, we have different products, their ID and so on. Now you are trying to display some sub products here under this part. So it's what we are going to do now. We go back to the design, and here now we are going to select we select our field here and then try to scroll here. We see here sub report. We are going to take it and try to put it down here in the empty area here. Then we go and create a new sub report thing. Yeah, next, and here we select a blank report. Same things goes here. We go here and we select master detail. Yeah, here we call it detail reports, and then we click next. Coming back here, sample database. Then here we go. You want to create some positions, so we try to select all from positions which will contain our sub products. Next, and here we select everything. We go to next. We don't group by, we group by nothing. Click next. Here we may try here to use the same connections, important, and then next. Here we don't add this one yet. We just try to skip this one. We can do it later. So here is it. Now we go back again to the design. And here we just come now, we come to the field, we select all fields except the products ID. So here is it again. We come again and select the static field. We try to design it again a bit. Here we give 16. And it's not finished with our design. So we try again to centralize them, and then the border, if you remember the border here, yeah, there were no border here. Okay, so it's no border. Then now what we come here, we move this one up, we select the field, and we come again to the text field, we come to center, we select the font, we put them to 18, that's too much. We go to 16, and then we try to add the borders. Here we just only want to put the vertical borders. And here the price. So that is it. Footer, we don't need all these things in the sub report. What we don't need, we take it off. We don't need all these things. So we remain only with this small sub reports. And now if we preview it, so here is our sub report, which is taking looks very interesting. And now here is where the important thing start. For example, here we start first with the text field. We just try to put the pattern number pattern that we want to see. So let's put, we just put like a hash comma hash hash 0, and then with this one just to name this, and we preview it. Yeah, you can see here it's much better now, not bad. Then we go back again now, select this one, then come to our reports here, and what we do now is we try to move everything closer, fit this area, and now we move the details up to this one. We can minimize again the sub report to have the height a bit smaller. Then we go with the details band here, overlapping. Okay, that is it now. Now the interesting part is coming here. that in our sub-report now you want to add a parameter here which will take the ID from the details and add it. So here we call it product. Product ID, and here we call it integer, and the default that we are going to assign to that will be new integer with 1 as default. So our parameter is created. Now we come and edit the query. Here you want to select where product ID is equal our parameter. We start with dollar and then we open the brace. We open the brace, then we write the parameter name. I think it's okay. If it's okay and we come here, we try to refresh the data, you can see BAM is working here. So, and our parameter is working now. We save the report and compile it. Then we come to the master. And we select our sub reports, come here to sub reports, and we come and click on edit parameter. Under edit parameter, here, what we are going to do here is here you are going to select our product ID, and here under this one we are going to, so very important here, so here you are selecting the parameter which is the product ID in the detail table. And here we go to the master table. Here we want to correspond it to the ID. So we select the ID here. Then it's done. We select it, save it, compile. And now if I haven't forgotten anything, and if we run our reports, bam, you can see now that for each reports now, so for each reports now we are going to have some prices here. So we have some sub reports, you can see here are some sub reports. We go to next. Here for second one we have some sub reports that are below. Here is the telephone, and here we have some sub product of the telephone type, and so forth and so on, the wheelchair and so on. So in short, this is how you can create your sub report in Jasper report. This was just intended to show you the basic way of creating a sub report. In the next tutorial I will are going to improve these designs. And probably if something is wrong, I will also show you probably here this price here is not showing correct, but the structural way you got it. Stay tuned. The video has already been long. I have to stop it now. And if you have any comment, do not hesitate to drop it down. Do not miss my next tutorial. Bye.